ich möchte die verehrten Festgäste ein Wort des Dankes, besonders an den Professor Robert Zinser, ausbringen. Ich habe gedacht, dass viele meiner Landsleute, die hier sind, die deutsche Sprache nicht mehr mächtig sind. Und deswegen bitte ich, ein paar Worte in Englisch zu sagen, damit so weit wie möglich auch die, die ferngereist sind, auch irgendwie auch mitbekommen können. In der Kirche habe ich 20 Minuten reden dürfen und keiner kann mich stoppen. Aber hier weiß ich, sie haben jetzt das Recht über mich. Und ich werde auch gehorchen. Hier beginnt die Zivilgesellschaft. Just to make it very short, as we sit here in this hall and enjoy this dignified audience, 40,000 children die every day. 40,000. And they die because they have no food, and they have no water, and they have no medication. As we sit right here now and enjoy this meal, over 60 million human beings have no homes. The rains fall on them, and they live like, probably you might say, even like animals in various places. Refugees are being pushed back in some areas of the world. God bless Germany. Many will not understand. Many will not understand, but Germany is like the conscience of the world. At a time when people are building walls, and with walls you cannot create a humanity, Germany is giving a very difficult sign that with its wealth, it can give a human response to human needs at a particular time, just because this world is one world. I would like to appreciate the fact that gathered in this room are human beings, people who have touched lives. The Rotary family, just to use the words of Professor Rademacher, and also what Dr. Schumacher said when he was making a speech, the Rotary family is able. The Rotary family has the goodwill. The Rotary family sets before itself the truth and the fairness for all. The Rotary family is an agenda for action that is inclusive and not exclusive. We need to live in a world where human beings can be respected in their dignity and their value for the simple reason that we are all human. God in heaven has made all human beings to his own image and likeness. What is happening here is that you, the friends of Robert, in the Rotary family and in his internal family, those who are here, you have in your various ways transformed the world. And you are doing it in measures beyond what the media can capture. You are doing this great work out of passion, out of belief that there is something good which can last. You who are gathered around Robert can be celebrated because you are worth celebrating. 90 years of life is not 90 years for nothing. It is 90 years that is filled with 60 years of marriage, with 20 years of Rotarian action for population and development, with 22 years engagement of Robert in Africa, with many, many years of friendships at many levels of each and every one of you, giving value to education. When I look around and look at your faces, many children can go to school, write their names and read and write, because you are giving them the ability. Many women, and when I look at Peter Noina here, or Robert Sinsa, or Professor Kunzel, or Werner Cordes, when I look at these and many other, with his foundation, the Werner Cordes Foundation, you are putting food on people's tables. But beyond that, you are making them to plant their own food. You are making them to think, to be authentic human beings. And the German development work of over 60 years plus, since the time of Konrad Adenauer, the German development work which we have known has tried to talk about from Bundesministerium für Wirtschaft to Bundesministerium für wirtschaftliche Zusammenarbeit. It is now a collaboration, a partnership of I help you to help yourself. Last week, I was in Washington. I was at the White House. President Obama had invited people to come together to share with him thoughts around a table on global peace, inclusiveness, and intercultural, interreligious dialogue. I made my voice heard. From that voice of people who come from the oldest continent in this world, Africa. People who have been the origin of wisdom and mankind, from where all others have gone, but those whom the brothers and sisters have continued to oppress. There in Washington, we made our voice clear that here in this world, no amount of walls can stop human beings from moving around. Just because the wind will blow down any wall that stops it. If water has to move and you put up walls, the water will push it down. The sunshine will shine on all persons wherever they are, including those who are causing all the trouble, like Boko Haram and ISIS. Even then, the sunshine goes to them. So we are being called to open up our doors, and Rotary is the best example. Explain to me that a man at his age, at 90, is planting trees for which fruit he's not going to pluck from. Children who are yet to be born will eat the mango trees and the oranges which Robert Sensah is planting. This is greatness. The bottom line, and I come to the conclusion, otherwise you will say I've started preaching. The bottom line, and I come to my conclusion, here in this world, it is not what we learnt, but what we teach others that matters. It is not what we have, but what we give to others that matters. It is not the properties I have accumulated, but much more of how I have shared it with others that matters. Probably, it is not what I wish to be, but who I am that matters. To plant trees, but not just to wait to reap from them. This is the life of Robert Sensah, and that is why I am here. I have collaborated with him for years, and I found out that we cannot in our world tolerate a system, Professor Radamaka used that word, a system where irresponsible reproduction of human beings continues to be a way of life. The Catholic Church preaches and teaches responsible parenthood. It is in the books. It is in the Vatican Council. Parents can only bring into this world as many children as they can responsibly take care of. So to bring in 20 children, 30 children, and push them there and tell the world you take care of them, that is not only irresponsible, it is even a sin. And here we discover that many people do not even know. And here awareness comes in. You have to teach them that every sexual activity can lead to a child. Therefore, you must take care. You must teach them natural family planning. You must teach them all other family plannings that exist so that they are in a position to make a choice. Because human beings must make a choice. That is the value of freedom. The freedom to choose, like they asked me today, between fish and red meat, and I chose fish. And some of you chose red meat. And some of you chose vegetarian. And some chose not to eat anything. And they brought red wine and white wine, and I looked at the fields of pictures, and I said, I will go to white wine, because I know what happens in Dutenhofen and Haslock and all those areas where white wine is planted. So freedom, the ability to choose, not only that I enjoy it, I should allow others profit from that freedom. So Rotarian Action for Population and Development, with Lufa Dajou and Dr. Kola and Professor Shitu, all from Nigeria, adding small, small voices to a large colossus. It makes the world a better place. So when I go now for my next meal, and I'm sure there will be a Drite or Fiete gang, when I go for that one, I will go with a good conscience that I am not eating alone. I'm eating to get energy to continue the good work for others worldwide. And that's why at Globe Ethics Net in Geneva, where since 3 months I've assumed the responsibility, we are trying to spread the good news, even at the level of the Club of Rome, that here on earth, God's work must become our own. Political ethics, environmental ethics, educational and research ethics, interreligious and intercultural ethics. God bless you all.